إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له كلمة قامت عليها الأرض والسماوات وفطر الله عليها البشرية وهي أساس الفرض والسنة ومن كان آخر كلامه لا إله إلا الله دخل الجنة وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومعلمنا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا يوم العرض على الله سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم صل عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وارض اللهم عن ساداتنا أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن الصحابة أجمعين وعنا معهم يا رب العالمين اللهم بلغنا رمضان اللهم بلغنا رمضان اللهم بلغنا رمضان اللهم اكتبنا فيه من الصائمين والصائمات والقائمين والقائمات اللهم اجعلنا ممن يصوم نهار رمضان ويقوم ليل رمضان اللهم ادخلنا الجنة من باب الريان اللهم ارحمنا في رمضان اللهم اغفر لنا في رمضان اللهم اعتق رقابنا ورقاب آبائنا وأمهاتنا من النار في رمضان يا رب العالمين اللهم آمين أما بعد My dear brothers and sisters, whenever we hear there is a big sale, a major sale coming up, we mark in our calendar, we make sure that, you know, we are going to, that day, we're going and we're going to buy everything that we need and even the things that we do not need, right? It's because it's a big sale, right? They say take, buy one and take one for free, or, you know, 50% off, or and so on and so forth. This is how, you know, this is our life, this is what we do. This is something that we do all the time. That's why, brothers and sisters, today I'm coming to you with a very good offer. It's an offer from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, an offer that will change your life, an offer that is not like any other offer, a seal that is not like any other seal that you've ever heard in your entire life. It's a seal in which when you buy something, you get 70. It's not only one for free, you get 70 for free. Right? It's the month of Ramadan, brothers and sisters. I see the smiles in the faces. I see the hearts are opening for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I see brothers and sisters are happy. I see the brothers and sisters are going to show the whole entire world that we are the followers of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and we can do it. We're ready to fast. We're so ready to stand for 20 rak'ah, maybe even more. We are ready to listen to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Show me, tell me any other religion or faith in the whole world that has the belief that we have Allahu Akbar. We are the followers of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I see the smiles in the faces. And this is the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The fact that we're still alive until now, it's a great opportunity, a great ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some people in the world passed away this morning, yesterday, the day before, they could not make it to the month of Ramadan. They could not make it, subhanAllah. However, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you and I the opportunity to live up to the month of Ramadan, to experience the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم أتاكم شهر عظيم. Here come to you a beautiful month, a great month. الشهر من صلى فيه فريضة كان كمن صلى 70 فريضة.
praying one salah, regular salah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because He loves you and I so much. They say, my servant, my dear beloved slave, I am giving you 70 in the word. I'm multiplying that. Pray once to do rak'ah sunnah, I'm giving you fariqah in other than Ramadan. Fast, and you having the door, the gate of a Rayyan. There is a particular gate for you, only for you, not for anybody else. Everyone will come in the day of judgment. Who are the fasting? Who fasted in dunya? Who fasted for the longest hours in the burning hot sun? Who did that? We did this, Ya Allah. You were our witness. We did that. We did not eat, we did not drink, we stayed away from haram things for so many hours. Ya Ibadi, all my slaves, my servants, here you go. This is Bab al-Rayyan for you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those people who will be selected to enter from the Bab al-Rayyan. Just think about it. Imagine that it's really hot in the Day of Judgment. And then the door of the gate of Rayyan is open. And everyone who fasted entering except you. It's not you. Go away from here. That is not for you. It's for the people who fasted for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, this is the great opportunity, the greatest opportunity in your life. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم خاب وخسر من أدرك رمضان ولم يغفر له. What a great failure, what a great loser. They said, قالوا من يا رسول الله؟ قال من أدرك رمضان ولم يغفر له. The one who experienced and witnessed the month of Ramadan and does not have his sins forgiven. It's the great loser, because what else you're waiting for? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is doing everything for you. You were complaining from shaitan, here you go, shayateen are going to be locked. What about the sins that people commit during the month of Ramadan? It is your nafs, because we have two enemies, and pay attention to this. There are two enemies, shaitan and your nafs, right? Ya nafsu tubi, some of the ulama and shu'ara, they said, ya nafsu tubi. They used to talk to themselves, to their nafs. Oh my soul, oh my nafs. Repent back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, return back, right? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took care of the shaitan. And this is a promise. So fidat al-shayateen. What about the sins? People commit all kinds of sins during the month of Ramadan. It's our nafs. Because we develop these kind of habits. You should not blame shaitan. Do not be unfair to shaitan. We are unfair to shaitan sometimes, right? Because even during the month of Ramadan, we blame everything on shaitan. Shaitan, you know? It's not shaitan, it's your nafs. You have to blame your nafs for that. Why? Because you developed the habit on doing all kind of haram things. Shahr Ramadan, ikhwani, has come to us to prove to us that we can do everything, we can change our soul. This is the month of revolution, brothers and sisters. You have to have this kind of revolution inside your heart, inside yourself. Yes, you can get rid of any bad habit in your life. The month of Ramadan has proven to us this, has proven the whole entire world that you can do everything. You can change yourself. You can control your nafs. Allahu Akbar. You have the halal food. You have the halal wife. You have the everything is halal. However, and your nafs is trying to drag you to go these things. And then you tell your nafs, ya nafs tubi, this is Ramadan. Stay away from that. Stay away from that. You're talking to your nafs and everything is halal. What about the haram things then? You'll not even think about it. Subhanallah. This is the idea behind Ramadan. If you can abstain and, you know, stay away from halal things, from Fajr to Maghrib, what about haram things? This is the month of Ramadan, brothers and sisters. Great opportunity from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Doors of Jannah are opening for you. Try to open up your heart. Come close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not say that I don't worship Allah the rest of the year. Don't worry about that. Don't worry about that. Come to the masjid. Come to the masjid. Do not think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, hey, you did not worship me, or you were not a good believer in Sha'ban or Rajab or the previous months. Don't come now. Never. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will always, always open doors for you. He will never turn you back. Never. Try Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just try that. clean your heart and come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, humble yourself, and you will see the bounties and the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is an athar, like a saying, it's a witch, to be honest, it's not, you know, a strong like hadith or something like that. But Musa alayhi salam asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, Ya Allah, ماذا تقول لعبدك إذا جاءك وهو طائع? What would you say to your servant when he comes? When he comes to you and he is obedient, he's a good servant. He said, I say, لبيك يا عبدي, here I am for you, my servant. And then Musa alayhi salam said, فماذا تقول له إذا أتاك وهو عاصي? What would you say to him? If he comes to you, if he comes near to you, right? If a repentant comes back, but he was disobedient, he was عاصي. What would you say, Ya Allah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أقول له, I say to him, لبيك 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 يا عبدي. Allahu Akbar. Three times saying, come back to me. Khwani, the month of Ramadan, delivered this message to us, shows us this. Come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not let this month go like this. Do not make your life before Ramadan just like after Ramadan and no change. Do not make Ramadan one of the Ramadans. It should be the only Ramadan in your life. Imagine that this is the only Ramadan in your life. How are you going to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala this month? Brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and there is only one ayah in the Quran, it's very famous. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the month of Ramadan. شَهْرُ رَمَضَانَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ فِيهِ الْقُرْآنِ If you notice something here, you notice that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not say the month of Ramadan, the month in which people fast. شَهْرُ رَمَضَانَ الَّذِي يَصُومُ فِيهِ He did not say that. He said the month of Qur'an. Matter of fact, one of the reasons why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored the month of Ramadan because Quran was revealed during the month of Ramadan. Imagine, think about it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored Ramadan because of Quran. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. Why the month of Sha'ban does not have the same value as Ramadan? Because Quran was not revealed in Sha'ban, it was revealed in Ramadan. Right? شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. This is the month of Quran, إخواني. The ulama and the salihin, they used to leave everything behind and focus on Quran. Focus on that book, that month. And you will see the change in your life. Try to reconnect with the Quran. You know your schedule better. You know your life better. But get back to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Again, لا يكن همك نهاية المصحف. أو نهاية القرآن. Do not focus too much on making khatma. You want to finish. It's good to read as well, of course. There's no question about it. But don't make your own goal, your prime goal is what? Finishing the Quran, reading from Alif Lam Mim to what? Min al Jinnati wal Nas. This is not how you should study Quran. One ayah, few ayahs every day, but it's time to understand what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking to you. من أراد أن يكلمه الله فليقرأ القرآن. If you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to speak with you, read the Quran. What if you want to talk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What a great honor. You pray. Because you say, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is responding back to you. So the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you should understand it. Right? Try as much as you can to apply it in your daily life. This is the month of Quran. Start from now. Tell yourself that after Ramadan, I will be able to understand as many ayat as I can from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not leave it in the shelf to just collect dust from here and there. That's why I am totally against using your phone when you read Quran all the time. That is not the best. Yes, sometimes when you have Quran in your pocket or here and there, you can try to read from your application or from your phone. But now we have Quran, alhamdulillah. We have this, you know, we have access to Quran everywhere, right? Do not let Quran collect the dust. This is your life. This is your oxygen. This is your medication. This is everything for you. You know when you go to a physician and he writes a prescription and he says, listen, if you don't take the pills, what's going to happen? You're going to die. But instead of taking the prescription and go to any pharmacy to get the medication, you know what you do? You leave it on the shelf. What's going to happen to you? You're going to die. This is the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فيه شفاء للناس. there is a heal in this book, there's a guidance in this book, but instead of you opening the book and understanding what is in the book, you just take it and put it in the shelf, right? And even you pick it up maybe in Ramadan, after Ramadan, at the end of Ramadan, you say, see you next year, inshallah. This is what happens, everybody. شَهْرُ رَمَضَانَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ فِيهِ الْقُرْآنِ. Prepare yourself. Now, even if you didn't fast in Shaban, don't worry about it. Don't worry about that. Just start. Start with the Muslimin. Start with the Muslimin and try to have taqwa. This is the main reason why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us Ramadan. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Achieve taqwa. It's a great opportunity to teach your kids taqwa from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What do I mean by that? How can you do that? Your kids, they're going to be with you home. And when they're home, you can tell if they're fasting or not. They're fasting while you're home, but when they go out, when they leave the house, what are they going to do? Are they going to continue fasting? That's a question. Are they going to do this? Talk to them. Tell them, listen, son, listen, my daughter. I'm here with you here, but I'm not with you outside. But Allah can see you. Allah can see you. Nobody's forcing you to fast, but Allah can see you. This is the taqwa that we're looking for, ikhwani. This is the kind of taqwa. You can just leave the masjid and go outside, do anything. Eat, drink, do anything you want. But the reason why you don't do that, because of taqwa. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what you're doing. No, don't worry about people, you worry about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this Ramadan the best Ramadan of our life. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our sins, Ya Rabbil Alameen. اللهم آمين أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد أحبتي في الله, we continue with the ayah, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم ومن كان مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر. الله سبحانه وتعالى wants ease, not hardship. He wants ease to you. Beautiful ayah. What did he mention that ayah, this ayah here, or this particular sentence here? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has shown us, ikhwani, that you can fast 30 days of Ramadan, but if you try to do that outside Ramadan, it's going to be almost impossible. Almost impossible. We fast one day, only one day outside Ramadan, and Allahu Akbar, we're dead by the end of the day. But the month of Ramadan, sometimes Maghrib comes and you're not even hungry. You can continue on fasting. Allahu Akbar. That's the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, fast, don't worry. I am going to make it easy for you. And this is our experience. The non-believers outside, they wonder, how do you guys do that? How many times do you hear this question? For young people, how many times you heard in your school? How do you guys do that? Why do you torture yourself? It's a torture. It's not torture, it's a training, it's a course. You're training yourself, you're training, you are controlling your nafs, because your nafs, if you let your nafs, you know, does everything, you know, it desires, you're going to do all kind of haram things. You're going to do like animals. What is the difference between humans and animals? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has elevated the status of humans and He gave them the opportunity and He gave them the ability to control their desires, unlike animals. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us brains, right? And in the meantime, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not give angels the desire. They had the brain, but not the desire. So, if you control your nafs, you're going to be in a better position and a situation, a higher level than angels. But if you don't control your nafs, what's going to happen? Now, what's the difference between the human and the animal now? Because the animals, whenever they want to eat, they eat. Whenever they want to do this, they do it in the street, anywhere. Why? Because they don't have the brain, but they have the desire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored you as a human being. He honored you. He said, control your nafs. How can we do that? Here you go, the month of Ramadan. The month of Ramadan is here. We have a lot of people in the world, millions in the world, they fast 365 days. They fast. Why? Is it because of Ramadan the whole year over there? No. It's because they don't have food. They don't have food. SubhanAllah. Prepare yourself. You never know. We live in luxury now. But Allahu A'lam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us from His bounties, Ya Rabbi Alameen. You never know. If that day comes, you prepare, because the month of Ramadan has changed you. The month of Ramadan taught you. Now we all. So the month of Ramadan trains you for the race. You know that in the Olympics, they prepare themselves very well before the game, right? Before it starts. And when it comes, all right, they're ready for that. But for us, Ramadan is the start. And when you train yourself during the month of Ramadan, now you are ready for the battlefield. What's the battlefield? The battlefield is Shaitan again. You're coming back to Shaitan. Here I am, but I'm strong now. I'm strong. I have learned from Ramadan. I am strong enough to face you. Before, I was a little weak, but here I am. I have power right now. Where did you get this power from? I got it from Ramadan. This is the conversation between us and Shaitan, brothers and sisters. That's why Ramadan is very important. But unfortunately, what happens? The last day of Ramadan, we lose the battle right away against Shaitan. We lose the battle. You know? This is what happens. Imagine that you exercising a lot and you're studying so much for a test, right? And you're working so hard. You don't sleep. You don't eat. You don't drink. And on the day of the test, the exam itself, you leave the paper empty and you leave. This is what we do. SubhanAllah. This is exactly what we do. That's why you stay strong. And know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you power over shaitan. Inna ibadi laysa laka alayhim sultan. This is the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the very beginning, He said that to shaitan. Inna ibadi laysa laka alayhim sultan. My sincere servant, you have no power over them. You have no power over them. Shaitan is not stronger than you. You are stronger than shaitan. And shaitan and Ramadan has proven to you that you are stronger than shaitan, you are stronger than your desire, you are stronger than anything else. And this is what we learned from the month of Ramadan. Khwani, inna li badalika alayka haqq. Your body is ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it has rights upon you. And to be honest, this is the whole idea of the month of Ramadan, is again to control your nafs and your desires. And food is one of the desires, of course. Alhamdulillah, wa kulu wa shrabu, eat and drink from the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But do not harm your body. We gain weight in Ramadan rather than losing weight in Ramadan. SubhanAllah. And this is an issue. No matter how hard we try to talk, how much we talk about it, I cannot find a solution for it, to be very honest. Because no matter how much we say, do not eat too much Ramadan and eat, follow the sunnah of Rasulullah, that is not going to happen. With the word biryani and all of this beautiful and delicious food, there is no solution for it. Just know that لِبَدَنِكَ عَلَيْكَ حَقْ. Your body has عَلَيْكَ. He has haqq on you. He has right upon you. Try to fulfill this right during the month of Ramadan. So you, when you eat according to the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the date, and then the water or milk or whatever, you come to the masjid here and you're comfortable, right? But if you eat too much, and this is what happens, you come to the masjid for Taraweeh, and as soon as before the imam even finishes al-Fatiha, you're really tired. Why is it taking long today? He doesn't have his finish, he didn't start. You know, but this is what happens because of the food. Remember, ثُلُثٌ لِطَعَامِكْ ثُلُثٌ لِشَرَابِكْ وَثُلُثٌ لِتَنَفُّسْ. One third for your stomach, right? One third for your the food, for the water, and one third for your breath, right? Otherwise, what we do in Ramadan, unfortunately, the three thirds, right, we use it for one thing, which is the food, SubhanAllah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us and give us tawfiq, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Month of Ramadan again, and we'll conclude with that. It's a great opportunity for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Take it or leave it. I would highly recommend that you take it, because you never know if it's going to come back or not. This is the message. Say that to yourself. Some people close to us passed away yesterday and the day before. Some people, they were here, but they're not here with us now, right? They lost this opportunity. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wa ghafur rahim, but He has given you another opportunity. Show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you deserve it.
Show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you're looking for His mercy for the gate of the Rayyan, Ya Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because from the people who enter them from the gate of the Rayyan. Allahumma ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit aqdamana وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين اللهم بلغنا رمضان اللهم بلغنا رمضان اللهم بلغنا رمضان اللهم اجعلنا من الصائمين والصائمات والقائمين والقائمات اللهم اجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا ونور أبصارنا وشفاء صدورنا وشفاء صدورنا اللهم علمنا القرآن اللهم علمنا القرآن اللهم تقبل منا صلاة التراويح اللهم تقبل منا الصيام والقيام يا رب العالمين ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر ولذكر الله أكبر الله يعلم ما تصنعون وأقم الصلاة سلموا الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا
إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَا سلام هي حتى مطلع.